All right, this hand looks a little different, but still I think good. I mean, can play a turn two Baleful Strix or Dryad Sophisticate, and I've got Time Warp and Mirror Battlesphere ready to go. I think that's a sweet combo if I can wait to resolve Battlesphere to a Time Warp. Curse Catcher, huh? Interesting. Do I want to trade for Curse Catcher? You know, I actually no. I gotta play Baleful Strix. The reason that I want to play Strix here is that next turn I can play Mind Stone and Dryad Sophisticate, so it's much better to get to play both my creatures instead of just one, even if I don't end up wanting to trade, which I don't think I do. One use for Time Warp potentially here, which looks kind of likely. Ooh, Scalding Tarn. My opponent's got into Volcanic. Yeah, my opponent's got great mana. Is a Time Warp to cast Battlesphere a turn earlier, which is kind of mundane, but might be the plan. Ooh, Searing Blaze. All right. See you later, Baleful Strix. Reman's nice. I'm still just gonna play the Dryad Sophisticate though, partially because Reman gets countered by Curse Catcher if I play Mind Stone, and I really do want to play the Mind Stone. So this actually probably will trade for Curse Catcher. I'm on a slightly bigger plan here, and I would like to be able to resolve Time Warp without any issue. And also, I don't like this race, so just because I'm gonna win, I think, with Mirror Battlesphere, which is doesn't care about random damage from a Dryad Sophisticate. All right, let's just pass. I don't need to Time Warp now. My opponent's not doing anything or using the mana, so just pass. I keep Remand up, and then next turn, well, maybe I'll Time Warp next turn. All right, well, if this is what's happening, then I'm a little more likely to want to do the Time Warp and then cast a Battlesphere. Let's see if my opponent leaves counter magic up. Looks like it. If I draw a relevant play, ooh, that is a relevant play, if I've ever seen one. All right, let's play Archmage. I actually should have played Underground River to have double blue up. Let's see if my opponent does have a counter spell. Does not. Well, that's pretty nice. So now I get to potentially cast Battlesphere with counter magic up if I wait two more turns and then Time Warp. Though I don't even know if I need to Time Warp. So after Battlesphere, I might just Time Warp next turn. So if my opponent plays a non-creature, I get to Archmage. Opponent plays a creature, I get to Remand. So either way, I'm looking pretty good. All right, activating Fairy Conclave. Well, I'll definitely block against a deck that has potentially a lot of burn spells. This seems pretty easy. Let's see if my opponent uses the timeout to resolve something. Nope, guess not. All right, so what's next? Cunning Spark Mage. That'd be pretty good. Brimstone Volley on me. Oh. Could just sack the Archmage. Yeah, that seems fine. I could have remanded it, but I think just sacking Archmage and then tapping out for Mirror Battlesphere seems like the best plan of action. Or course of action. Or plan. All those things. Alright, so now I'm at 14. I'm not going to die this turn, barring some very, very strange sequence of cards. And then next turn, I get to attack for 12, and then Time Warp, and then with Remand back up, so. Feeling pretty good about this. Yeah, I've got the triple blue. Everything's coming up Battlesphere. Unless you have a control magic or something, like a Sword of Temptation, that would be a beating. Well, if that happens, oh, Dungeon Geists. Okay, that's a thing. Makes my squad a little less imposing. So now I might need to cast Shadow Mage and then Time Warp, which is also a combo. Ooh, Goblin Guide, no attacks. Oh, attacking? All right. So I'm drawing a Night Veil Spectre, I guess. I mean, I'll trade for a Goblin Guide here. I think I'm just going to play Night Veil Spectre. And do I want to play Shadow Mage as well? Yeah, that sounds good. So let's play Shadow Mage. And then play Night Veil Spectre. I don't need Remand, I don't think. And then at least this way, if I do get to a turn where I get to attack with both, then Time Warp becomes insane value. And if my opponent does kill one, probably can't kill the other. I also need to be able to punish my opponent for attacking with Dungeon Geists. Uh-oh, what is this? Ooh, this could be bad. This costs a lot of mana. So maybe I should have left. Oh, never mind. It's Deep Analysis. I was going to say I should have left Remand up, but my opponent's just casting Deep Analysis and flashing it back, or Mogwar Marshal. I'm not too worried. Do you get in with Dungeon Geists? Sadly for me, no. All right, let's attack with the Shadow Mage. And I might Time Warp here. We'll see what I draw. It's a shame that it doesn't. I don't get to hit with the Night Veil Spectre. Let's draw a card off Mindstone, play a Pilgrim, just play an island and pass. I'm getting a little greedy here. I could Time Warp and get an extra card off Shadow Mage, but I kind of want the opportunity to Time Warp when I have a little bit more going on. I mean, I guess it's probably ambitious to wait till a Night Vale Spectre can hit because it's not happening anytime soon, and I don't really have a way to get rid of Dungeon Geists, but I think waiting until I have two creatures out that want to attack could be sweet. All right, if this is a deep analysis, yeah, we're definitely remanding that. That is some pretty good value. Boom. All right, so Master of Waves makes me want to Time Warp even better, and now I get to do both. All right, sweet. I get to cast Master off a lot of things, so I might actually just be able to kill my opponent here, or at least get pretty close. Hopefully that Dungeon Geist starts coming in. That would be awesome. All right, let's... Oh man, Oracle. Kind of want to go big here, but it doesn't really make any sense to do anything but play Master of Waves and cast Time Warp, so that is the plan. Ooh, Plow Under. Yeah, probably not going to need that one. All right, Urborg making things difficult as usual, so I get a lot of tokens, and then I get to Time Warp. So saving the Time Warp worked out. All right, bam. So I get to draw. I could play Oracle first, just in case I draw something relevant. I don't know if there is something relevant. All right, let's play the Swamp. And then let's hit with a bunch of things. Probably everything. Well, it's actually kind of awkward because my opponent can block Master of Waves with Dungeon Geist. So maybe not Master of Waves, maybe everything else. So let's see, my opponent blocks Dungeon Geist on Night Vale Spectre. Blocks two elemental tokens. So it takes 2, 4, 5, 11. I could attack with Master. Oh wait, no, there's another elemental 13. So that makes the other Master of Waves lethal. All right. So I think I get to attack with everything because my opponent blocks now Master of Waves, Night Vale Spectre, and token. Takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh. Wait, no, that's not actually great for me because I'm not doing four. No, it does 14. Okay. Nope, does 12 again. I keep miscounting. So 12. So let's not attack with Master of Waves then. Let's just send in, or Night Vale Spectre. Let's just send in all the rest of the idiots, and I think this is good enough. And then I get to Plow Under my opponent as well and draw an extra card off Shadow Mage. So I think I'm in good shape here. I guess I could attack with the Master under the logic that it's going to get Shrined next turn, but I think this works a little better. This at least forces my opponent to Shrine the Master of Waves and still leaves me with a lot of pressure. Alright, taking an extra damage to kill a token. That's fine. And so I could put my opponent to 1, basically. But I think this is good enough. Alright, drew Bad River, so I can play that. Edric next turn. Alright, I have 5 mana, but I actually don't have all the green mana. So, alright, we're just casting Noble Hierarch then. Wish I had left more blue-black up, but I think that's fine. All right, looking pretty good. I mean, I feel like I'm just, like, incredibly far ahead here, so I think that I'm going to be victorious. This deck does not have much removal. Opposition would have helped that, too, but I'll just have to hope that my, you know, high-quality creatures are enough to get me the wins here. I don't have enough disruption, so actually, there are definitely decks where I could run into some pretty big problems as a result of that. Luckily, I don't think my opponent can kill me here. I can chump Dungeon Geists if I need to. I get burned by like 2, 10, 5 damage burn spells and I go to 4 and then Shrine does 3 to me. That's like worst case scenario that my opponent somehow has a bunch of mythical 5 damage burn spells. Now, if my opponent had like a Wildfire or something, but I guess that would unlock Mirror Battlesphere and kill the Dungeon Geist. So that's not a current turn either. Ooh, what are we casting now? This costs a bunch of mana. 4 mana. Could this be like an Earthquake or something? 5 mana. Zealous Conscripts. Interesting. You can take like Mirror Battlesphere, but it's just a 4 power attacker. You can take Night Vale Spectre, but you'll draw Edric, so that's not great. Can't take Master of Waves. Alright, so you take Night Vale Spectre. Attack, and exactly what happens? Alright. I mean, it does let my opponent steal Edric, but I think I've just got lethal in play. It's Does my opponent have to play a land as the last card? I mean, yeah, it looks like that's it. All right, even if my opponent had a land to use Shrine, I think I would have been fine.